Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Mohammed Rafique Pitafi, lecturer in Government Degree College, Latifabad, Hyderabad. Today's my topic is blood from chapter number 14, first year. Blood is the circulatory fluid of a human body and mostly present in all type of closed type circulatory system possessing organisms. Human possess around about 4 to 5 liter blood. Blood is a red colored viscous connective tissue with colorless plasma. Blood consists on two parts. One is the plasma. Plasma is the non-living, and other are the blood corpuscles that are the living. Plasma is non-living, and it almost forms 55% of blood, and 90 to 92% of plasma is water, and remaining is protein and other inorganic and organic substances. Protein is about 6 to 8%. Fibrinogen, globulin, albumin are the special proteins of plasma. Fibrinogen needed clotting or coagulation of blood. It is responsible for the stoppage of blood from the injured part with platelets. Globulin primarily are involved in the defense system or weak inside the immune system, and albumin help in the osmolarity balance or weak inside the maintenance of solute and solvent inside the body. Defense system means immune system, protection system. Osmolarity regulatory balance means maintenance of solute and solvents inside the body. And other one third part of plasma is the inorganic materials, that is a sodium, calcium, magnesium, bicarbonate, ions, chlorine, and many other minerals, especially we eat, drink with water and food. And the other one is the glucose, amino acid, lipid. These are the organic substances. Carbohydrate or lipids. Glucose is the fuel of our body. Are also present in the plasma. They are always in transit in blood. Plasma without clotting factor, that's known as a serum. Means removal, after removal of fibrinogen and other factors of clotting, that remaining portion of blood is known as a serum. Other one are the living cells, that is the blood corpuscles. First one is the erythrocytes, or we can say the RBCs. Second one are the leukocytes, or white blood cells. Third one are the platelets, or we can say the thrombocytes. It formed around about 45% of blood. Erythrocytes are the red blood cells. These are the buses to transport the respiratory gases inside the body. Also known as RBCs are red blood cells. These are most abundant blood cells. A healthy adult man has about 5 to 5.5 million cells, 1 mm³. Blood. Red blood cells are formed in the red bone marrow in the adult. RBCs are devoid of nucleus in most of the mammalian or biconcave in shape. RBCs red colored because of iron present with the hemoglobin that give color to the cell in name also. A healthy individual possesses about 12 to 16 grams of hemoglobin in every 100 ml of blood. And these molecules play important role in the transport of respiratory gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen. RBCs have an average lifespan, that is 120 days to, or we can say the 4 months after destruction in liver and spleen. After that, destruction occur in liver and spleen. RBCs are very essential for the body, because these are especially for the transport of respiratory gases. That's why we are using that are the respiratory buses. Spleen is known as a graveyard of RBCs because erythrocytes or RBCs death mostly occur in the spleen. Second one is the leukocytes. Leukocytes are known as the white blood cells, colorless hemoglobin cells. They are nucleated and relatively lesser in number. Array 6 to 8,000 present in 1 cubic millimeter. Blood, leukocytes are generally short-lived, 20 to 30 hours, one day. There are two main categories of WBCs. One is granulocytes. Granulocytes, also known as polymorphonucleotides, neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils. Neutrophils named on the basis of neutral stain, eosinophil on the basis of acid stain, basophil on the basis of basic stain, because all these three give color, especially in stains, that's why they are named. Agranulocytes, lymphocytes, and monocytes are the type of agranulocytes, or we can say the monomorphonucleotide. Granulocytes possess many shaped nucleus, that's why they are known as polymorphonucleotide nucleocytes. Agranulocytes having one single type of rounded, usually you can say the nucleus, that's why that name is monomorphonucleotide. And cytoplasm do not possess grains. Granulocytes further classified into neutrophils. Neutrophils are the most abundant cells, about 60 to 65 cells. These are phagocytic in nature. Basophil about 0.5 to 1% among them. It secretes histamine, serotonin, heparin, involving the inflammatory reactions. Eosinophil 2 to 3% resists infection and are also known, also associated with allergic reactions. Agranulocytes, lymphocytes 20 to 25% of major types. B and T forms are responsible for immune responses of the body. Monocytes 6 to 8% are phagocytic cells which destroy foreign organisms entering the body. Neutrophils and monocytes are phagocytic in nature. They directly eat or kill the microorganisms, while basophil, eosinophil, and lymphocytes, these are the especially cytotoxic in nature. While the neutrophil, basophil, eosinophil, and monocytes, these are non-specific, means response to all. These are not specific, while the lymphocytes are the specific. B lymphocytes only responds to the bacteria, fungus, and few other microorganisms and worms. T lymphocytes only responds to the viruses. And nowadays, coronavirus is means the mega problem of world. That's due to these T lymphocytes resistant ability. T lymphocytes is not properly resistant, involving the resistance of these viruses. And also HIV virus and coronaviruses, you can say body cannot respond directly because they are more dangerous and powerful than other. Platelets are the third corpuscles. Platelets, also known as the thrombocytes, are cell fragments produced from the megakaryocytes present in the bone marrow. It can release a variety of substances, most of which are involved in the coagulation or blood clotting, or reduction in their number can lead to the clotting disorder, which will lead to excessive loss of blood from the body. Blood normally contains about 1.5 to 3.5. Now we are moving towards the functions of the blood. Blood transports nutrients, means whatsoever we are eating or getting from the nutrients, that all move into the blood, that transport by the help of blood. Transport waste substances, either like ammonia, urea, uric acid, the excretory material of cell or tissues, that transported by blood. Transport hormones. Hormones are the endocrine secretions, means secretions that put into blood and transported, means glands secrete into blood and blood transport into the body. Distribution of body heat. Directly blood is not involved, but it carry heat from the tissues. When metabolism occur in tissues, that heat release into blood and blood carry towards the skin and pass out from the body in the form of perspiration, into the perspiration. Transport respiratory gases, that is oxygen, carbon dioxide, defense against the disease, that done by the help of WBCs. WBCs are the soldiers, police of the body, and they help to protect us from the invaders, or we can say the enemies. WBCs kill microorganisms as well as our body own cancerous cells also, because cancerous cells produce inside the body ultimately. Those do not having proper immune system inside the body that suffer from the cancer. Protection against own loss, clotting, dead cells, tissues that transported by the help of this one. So thank you very much. This is request to all students, kindly listen it carefully. If you have any question, query, you can contact me, text me on this number. This is my WhatsApp number, 0300-311-4381. And also subscribe my channel. I have showing this. You can see Pitafi word and experiences. Thank you.